A new study shows an unexpected reason for diabetes. Published in Diabetologia, the Journal of European Association for the Study of Diabetes shows that exposure to outdoor artificial light at night is linked to poor blood sugar control and a higher risk of diabetes. Have you downloaded the SugarMD app yet? If not, you are missing out on some great resources for managing your diabetes. Our team of experts offer free coaching via app texting so you can get answers to all of your diet and diabetes related questions. More than 9 million cases of diabetes in Chinese adults can be linked to this light exposure at night. The study was done by Dr. Hu and his colleagues at Shanghai Institute of Endocrine and Metabolic Diseases. In modern societies, the artificial light exposure at night is a common environmental risk factor. The amount of light pollution from cities has gotten so bad that it is now affecting not only people who live in big cities, but also people who live in suburbs and forest parks, hundreds of miles away from the light source. Over 80% of the world's population is exposed to light pollution at night, but scientists haven't paid much attention to this problem until the last few years. Because of Earth's 24-hour day-night cycle, most organisms, including mammals and us, we are mammals, right? We have a built-in circadian rhythm. It's a clock that is adapted to the natural order of light and dark. Scientists have found that the light pollution changes the circadian rhythm of insects, birds, and other animals, which can lead to early death and even loss of species. Artificial light exposure at night also has been linked to metabolic dysregulation because it can change the timing of when people eat. Rats that were given artificial light exposure at night became unable to handle glucose, which caused their blood sugar and insulin levels to rise. In another study, mice that were exposed to dim white light at night for 4 weeks had a bigger body mass and less tolerance for glucose than mice that were in a completely dark environment at night, even though they ate and used about the same amount of energy. Artificial light exposure at night has also been linked to health problems in people. A study of people who worked the night shift found that those who were exposed to brighter light exposure at night were more likely to have problems with their circadian rhythms and a higher risk of coronary heart disease. Other research found that higher light exposure at night was linked to a 13 to 22% increase in the likelihood of being overweight and obese, respectively, and that exposure to that light in the bedroom was linked to the development of diabetes, especially in older people. A study in South India used satellite images to map the light pollution and compared this to the information about adults' general health markers in that area, for example, that showed that what possible effects of outdoor artificial lights could be causing on people. With increasing light exposure at night, with the intensity, the average body mass index, systolic blood pressure, the bad cholesterol were increasing in those exposed populations. Now, as you know, diabetes is a major public health problem, not only in the US, but also in China. And a lot of what causes it and makes it worse are things people do and things in people's environment. Due to the country's rapid urbanization and economic growth, the number of people exposed to city lights has gone up dramatically. People who live in cities tend to move away from a natural 24-hour day-night cycle and toward a round-the-clock cycle of work and play. They often stay out late and they're exposed to artificial light at night because of that. The study used information from the China Non-Communicable Disease Surveillance Study, which is a sample of the general population of China taken in 2010 at 160 cities all over the country. A total of 100,000 adults took part and they were interviewed to get information about their age, their health, their household income, lifestyle, education, family history, and so forth. The average age of the people who took part was around 43 years of age, and about half of them were women. Participants' weight and height, they were used to figure out their BMI, and the blood samples were taken to find out their fasting and postprandial, which is after a meal, glucose levels in their blood, as well as their A1C levels, right? Which is you're, I'm sure, a big fan of. This is the type of glucose that is, if you didn't know, attached to hemoglobin structure in your red blood cells. It shows how much sugar has been running around in the last 8 to 12 weeks. Now, U.S. Defense Meteorological Satellite Program nighttime low-light images of the Earth's surface were used to give each study site's participants an average artificial outdoor light exposure level for that site. Exposure levels were ranked from lowest to the highest and put into 5 quantiles, groups of 20% from highest to lowest, okay? The median light intensity in the highest quantile was 60 times higher than the lowest. Now, China had a lot of different levels of light exposure at night. Most places had low levels, but the eastern coastal cities had the highest levels. People who lived in places with more outdoor light exposure at night were more likely to be older. They have a higher BMI, they have a higher household income, they lived in a city. People in lower quantile areas, on the other hand, said they were more active, but they had less education. The study found that in areas with the most light exposure at night, the number of people with diabetes was 28% higher than in areas with the least light exposure at night. Even after taking into account many important diabetes risk factors, chronic exposure to residential light exposure was linked to higher glucose levels, higher insulin resistance, and number of people with diabetes. It was also linked to lower beta cell function. For every 42 people who live in areas with the highest level of light exposure at night, there is one more case of diabetes that would not have happened if those people had lived in areas with the lowest level of light exposure at night. Even though the link between light exposure at night and diabetes might not be as strong as with other known risk factors, the fact that artificial light is so common outside means and a large number of people are exposed to that is an important fact. Now, researchers thought that outdoor light exposure could be to blame for more than 9 million cases of diabetes in Chinese adults over the age of 18. This number is likely to go up as China becomes more urbanized and more people move from countryside to cities. The fact that about 83% of the world's population and more than 99% of those in the US and Europe live under light polluted skies shows how big and global problem that is. These results add to the growing body of evidence that light exposure at night is bad for your health and show that it may be a possible new risk factor for diabetes. The authors come to the conclusion that further studies that directly measure people's exposure to light at night are needed to find out if the link between light exposure at night and the diabetes is a strong one. So, I found this interesting. I hope you did too. And if you did, please give a thumbs up, share this video, let us know what you think. And thank you for watching. And most importantly, have a wonderful day or evening. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying this channel so far and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it. And if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.